Tokozani, Sobona, greetings. It's me, Gogo Tule. I wanted to do a quick video answering a really beautiful question that I got about connecting to our roots in the diaspora. Even though I'm considered African American, I'm not exactly the average African American. Most of you know that I was born in West Africa, Burkina Faso. My family came to the United States when I was really young, and I was raised here on the East Coast. And so only my youngest sibling was the first one in my immediate family who was born here in the States. And so I don't have generations of family members who were raised and had the African American experience. I've been to my father's village, and even though I'm still discovering things about who we are, I can at least trace back one or two generations of information. So one, I just feel like the question, my answer is going to be slightly different because I don't have the average experience of most African American people. And I just felt the need to, you know, make that clear for those who don't know. One of the first ways that I want to answer this question is that it requires a lot of patience and a lot of time. You know, for example, the Umbungoma tradition, the tradition that I initiated into, you know, back in the day, they said that these initiations, these coming back into the medicine and the wisdom of our ancestors would be 10 to 20 years long of learning, of searching, of recollecting and remembering that wisdom. So I don't have any quick answers. A lot of the things that I have come to learn and discover took a lot of time, a lot of dedication, a lot of frustration, and a lot of just patient and constant seeking and actively doing so. And there were times where I didn't even know, you know, I didn't know what I was doing. I was just pushing forward and opening myself up to receive. So, you know, one of the most important things that I did was that I chose a spiritual path. You know, a lot of us come into this spiritual world a lot of different ways. For me, my entry was through New Age teachings. And though some of the New Age teachings can be problematic in some ways, it was my entry point. It opened up the way and it got me to where I am now. And so sometimes we, you know, there's a lot of options out there. There's a lot of things that we can be doing and trying. It's important to just go with what you've been guided to first. If you're getting into meditation, if you're getting into yoga, if you're getting into ritual, choose that path and dedicate yourself to it. Sometimes it's not always important which way or how or, you know, all of that extra information when you're starting off. It's about, you know, one of the things that the spirits really respect is devotion and consistency. So if you have chosen a path, if you have chosen a practice, and you are working towards being consistent, devoting yourself to it and opening yourself up to it in a way that is not pressuring or restricting or forcing time, is really going to be important. So devotion. You know, one of the aspects of this path and this tradition, whether it's African spirituality, you know, there's different scopes, there's different aspects of our roots. And it's, you know, at the core of it, there's always been community. There's, you know, behind every spiritual tradition, there's temples, there are elders, there are spiritualists, there are priests, and so it's important to seek and find some type of mentorship or guidance or assistance, aid, spiritual readings, divinations, you know, ways to tap into the ones who are still holding the wisdom and the medicine. And not so much so that we can become completely dependent on them, but so that we have somebody to assist us in interpreting the information that we're receiving. To me, one of the things about finding your roots is that it's an aspect of it is a self journey. It's not something that somebody else can do for you. Yes, we definitely have beautiful options like doing DNA tests and looking through our family tree and all of these things. But you're also going to receive information through non-physical means, psychic experiences, dreams, visions. And a lot of times people are having, you're receiving information, your roots, no matter what this world and these systems try to do, there's nothing that they can cut. They can't ever really cut your roots off. You know, just like nobody can take the earth beneath our feet. Yes, we will always be connected. So it's just about understanding how that connection and experience is bringing the memories back, is bringing the signs and the symbols. And to me, the hardest part of this journey has been interpreting and understanding the signs and the symbols of the spirits and how our ancestors did things, and how they are trying to communicate information to us. Yes. So with that, one of the things that I always talk about is that we have to open ourselves up to trusting our intuition, understanding our intuition, and understanding the signs and symbols and omens of life. There are so many things that I've learned on this spiritual journey. And then I looked back at my early childhood and, you know, growing up, and how there were certain things happening to me when I was younger that I had no idea was connected to my roots. I had no idea was connected to my ancestors. But now that I have the information, I can look back and make that connection. So one of the main things that I try to teach or tell people is that, or show people, is that you're already receiving information. You're already having experiences that are connected to your roots. And so it's about opening up to understanding how this information is, what it means and what it's saying to you. Yes, what that dream means and how you are to apply it and what that means about who you are and where you come from. You know, one of my, and this is just a simple, small example, but, you know, I recently discovered that I have this beautiful, one of my spiritual guides in the form of an animal totem. And the other day I was just thinking about how when I was a baby, I only had like two earrings when I was younger that I ever wore. If you see pictures of me when I was younger, I only had like these same earrings on. And one of these earrings was an animal that now I know to be my totem. So I have a lot of little examples like that where I see that the spirits were showing me who I am, showing me where I come from. And, you know, I also have an elder once told me that, you know, the earth is our first ancestor. You know, the bones of our ancestors are in this earth. The things that they lived, the memories of those things are in this earth. So a big part of connecting to our roots is finding ways to connect back with nature. Finding ways to spend time with nature. When they say that we have all the elements within us, we have the air, we have the water, we have the fire, it also means that we have the people and the spirits that govern or work with those energies. So the more time you spend in fire rituals, the more time you spend in water rituals, the more time you spend with the earth, it's going to invoke the memories. It's going to invoke the stillness. It's going to alleviate the things that are in the way of us connecting with who we really are. The stress that we carry, the problems that we face, the thoughts that we're thinking in our mind, 15 minutes to hours spent in nature is going to help release that and let it go. And then we can finally have information come in that these stresses and these blocks are prohibiting us from experiencing and understanding. So, you know, when you look at indigenous cultures and traditions, they are not only in nature, they are wearing the symbols of nature. They are understanding the rhythm of nature. They are speaking, learning to speak the language of nature. So to me, you know, a big part of rites of passages and ceremonies and initiations are about becoming one with nature again. And when that happens, it's like, you know, we speak about the ancestors being in the water. So in order to return to them, we have to go to those places and spend time and understand how those elements and those forces work in our lives. Another aspect that I kind of wanted to bring up is, you know, looking into your family stories. Sometimes, you know, there are certain things that I didn't know about my family until I was on this journey and I started asking questions. And I almost had to, you know, put on like an anthropology hat and find creative ways to ask my parents things just about us. One of the things is that, you know, some of your parents, your uncles and your aunts are doing things that your grandparents and your grandparents did. And they don't even realize that it's a ritual, or they don't even realize that it goes centuries and generations back. There are certain ways of doing things when a child was born, or people were married, or they had this problem, or how they became successful in creating markets and businesses. Like, these are things that are all connected to our roots because they're not the first ones that did it. And the things that they use, whether it's herbs or techniques, and the prayers that they said, yes, whether they were Christian prayers or prayers in other languages, the fact that they did those things over and over and over again generated a certain energy and frequency that you are also connected to. Makosi. I remember one time my mom, you know, was telling me about something that she does that she doesn't even think about it as a ritual. But if you research African spirituality, you will see this ritual named again and again and again as a way of connecting with the ancestors. So we have to open ourselves up to really looking at our families and also looking at your personal experience. From a traditional perspective, they say that the way that you were born, the way that the umbilical cord was wrapped around you, can say a lot of things about who you are and who you came into this world to be. So, you know, knowledge of self, knowing about your astrological sign and how the stars were aligned when you were born, knowing about and even if you were to just pick like three or five cultures and indigenous traditions, if you were to look at the root work in African American spirituality in America and Native American spirituality and Sangoma or Yoruba, and you also pick the Mayans and the Celtics, and you just read a little bit about what they did that connected them to the roots, you're going to see a string of similarities. There is something that all people did across all time, though we have different variations. I like to think that we are all, you know, all the different traditions are all different artists with a different perspective, sharing the same thing. Just beginning to learn about the way that the people of the earth have done things is going to link you back to your roots. It's going to show you what was there. Yes. And when you start to incorporate some of those simple things, the ancestors will guide you to their version of it.
Yes.
At least that's my perspective. One of the last things that I'll say is that if you look at also any spiritual tradition, any rooted way of being, when people didn't know something, when they were having a hard time, when they were lost, when they were disconnected, when they were looking for enlightenment, they decided to go through a period of fasting and prayer. You know, you can see this in the vision quests of the Native Americans. African traditions do similar things where you go out in nature and you still your mind and you fast and you pray. It's a really important thing to, when you don't know something, whether it's about yourself and your roots, whether it's about how to achieve your destiny, whether it's about how to be successful in your business, if you don't know something, and you should turn, you know, it's important to turn within. It's important to fast. It's important to detox. It's important to somehow shed some aspects of the world so that you can go inside of yourself and allow an answer, a clarity, a guidance, or an energy to flow through you.
Yes,
that will open you up to what you're seeking. So that's what I have to say on that for now. I'm open to more questions. And you know, I truly trust and believe that the spirits are guiding us and are getting us there. And as long as you stay committed, as long as you stay consistent and devoted, the way will open. There's lots of love and support around us. And though there are forces that try to work against us, you're more powerful than that. All right. Peace. Blessings.